Hi, I'm Annie and welcome to Gimme Lemons. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a very humble and very traditional Korean food called nurungji. If you watched my previous video, you have a little backstory and context for this food. If you missed it, you can find it easily in the link above or in the description below. First, I'll show you how to make the basic nurungji, and then some different ways you can enjoy it with my absolute favorite way at the end, so be sure to stick around. Now, as promised, let's get to it. First, heat a cast iron pan over medium-low heat. Add a drizzle of neutral oil and just enough cooked rice to cover the bottom of the pan. Here, I'm using about 200 grams for an 8-inch pan. Pat down the rice well with a dampened rice paddle, add about a tablespoon of water and keep patting it down every once in a while for about 15 to 20 minutes, depending on your heat and your nurungji color preference. While that's cooking, we can prepare the condiments. For a sweet version, traditionally my mom sprinkled the nurungji with plain sugar, but I found it's really good with cinnamon sugar. Simply mix a few tablespoons of powdered sugar with a teaspoon of cinnamon and put that aside. Another version is with furikake, a sweet, salty, crunchy Japanese condiment you can sprinkle on practically anything. More on that later. Finally, I'll be making sungnyung, a simple soup made from nurungji. It's plenty good plain, or you can get kinda fancy with a few condiments. Toast up some sesame seeds, slice some scallions, maybe add some gim, the Korean word for nori or dried seaweed, and either fry, poach, or soft boil an egg. Frying will give the dish extra texture, poaching or soft boiling will give it a luxurious dimension. I like mine fried crispy rather than perfectly emoji-like. I think egg whites have so much to offer with its crispy edges, don't you? Now let's take a look at how the nurungji is doing. As you pat it down, you'll be able to feel with the paddle that the bottom is becoming a single mass and crispy. Take it off the heat when it's right on the edge of scorched after about 15 to 20 minutes. As mentioned earlier, this is going to depend on the kind of cook you want on your nurungji and also the kind of heat you're working with. A lot of people seem to like roasting both sides, but I like the contrast of texture with the top still soft. It's also closer to what we used to eat as kids. Once that's off the pan and cool enough to handle, you can make the sungnyung or soup. You can also start another nurungji if you'd like to make a snack portion. Break up the nurungji into a pot, add some water to cover, and slowly bring it up to a boil. I'm using dashi here, but if you use water, you can also put some aside and drink it as a kind of roasted rice tea. Also really good. For the soup, I'm gonna cook it a little bit longer till it's slightly thickened and cloudy. It's plenty good on its own with a dash of salt or soy sauce, or you can top it with the condiments. This soup is totally the byproduct of frugality, made with plain water poured directly into the pot to get at the very last grains of rice. Thinking about that, I feel incredibly grateful and somewhat ironic for making this sort of fancy version with an electric rice cooker in the comfort of my warm home. For a sweet version, sprinkle the nurungji with the cinnamon sugar we mixed earlier, but my absolute favorite way to eat it is with the furikake. You can find it pretty much in any Asian market, but I'm cheap so I made this from leftover kombu and bonito flakes that I had left over after making dashi broth. It's simply roasted and mixed with sesame seeds and coconut sugar. So there you have it, three delicious ways to enjoy this very humble food called nurungji. If you'd like to support what I'm doing on this channel, please give the video a thumbs up and leave me a comment below. Also consider subscribing if you haven't already. And finally, if you make any of these dishes, feel free to tag me on Instagram. I love hearing from you and seeing your creations. Till next time, take care and see you in the next video.